Hi, I'm Victor Felberg with AIM Dynamics, and today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the eGauge 4000 series and how you can use it to monitor things other than just power. Typically, we would use this inside something like a panel to monitor each of the different circuits, and it has 15 CT inputs or 30 CT inputs depending on the model. This is the EG 4000 series. And what I'm going to be talking about today applies to anything in the 4000 series. It will not work with the 3000 series. So if you have one of the older eGauge models, this does not apply. I've ordered an ACI unit from our website, aimdynamics.com, and we'll get the exact model for you down in the description below. But this is how it comes. We'll open this up. And what you can see is we get a NEMA enclosure. Slip that down. We have a NEMA enclosure, and here at the bottom is the actual temperature sensor, and that's designed so that when it rains and so forth, there's not water collecting inside of that unit. We can open this up, little screws here. And inside what you see is we have a little tiny circuit board with the various power connections and output signal. Let's go into the lab now and take a look at how we're going to get this connected. We have our NEMA enclosure, and I've gone ahead and plugged in my eGauge into the DC power supply. Oftentimes, of course, you'll have the power coming from the AC lines instead, but a new feature with the 4000 series is that you can power from DC, which is great for a lab environment like what I have here. If we open up the NEMA enclosure, we'll go ahead and take a look at the board. Let's zoom in here and see what we can see. We have the connections. RTD is our thermistor, which is already connected, and we're not going to fiddle with anything there. One thing that you might think is that the plus would be the positive of the power supply and the minus would be the negative of the power supply. But that's not quite right. We're going to use the ground as the common of the power supply and the plus as the positive of the power supply. I found that confusing the first time I hooked this up. Notice that I have two wires coming out of the ground. One is the common of the power supply, and the second is the common on our signal, the signal being V0. Let's hook up a few more wires here. In this case, I'll be using a 15-volt power supply to power the unit. Our red positive, tie that together. One of the commons, let's plug that in. Now, here I've got this special unit. This is an AIM converter that's going to take the output of the temperature sensor and convert it into a signal that the eGauge can accept and read. On the input side, we're going to take the signal as the plus of the little converter. And I'll put the minus, or the common, into the negative of the AIM converter. I'll put a link down here where you can buy this package together. Now we have our power supply hooked up going into the input side, and the only thing left is to hook up the output. For the output, I'm going to hook the minus as the black wire and the plus as the white wire. That's going to go on the output side of the converter and into the eGauge device. We'll plug this into an available port. In this case, I have things set up on port 2, or the CT2 as it were. And then all that's left is one step of configuration, which I'm going to show you here in just a second. Let's turn on the power supply, and now we will get our data inside of the eGauge device. So I've logged into my eGauge unit using the URL, and one of the things that I'm going to do is I'm going to connect via the LAN so that we can make changes to the unit. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to click on Settings in the top right, and then over here on the left, I'm going to choose Installation. Inside of here, this is where we're going to go ahead and configure our units. You'll notice that it says current transformers, but as mentioned before with the 4000 series, you can monitor other things as well, such as temperature, humidity, gas, and things like that.
So over here, I connected my temperature sensor through that AIM converter to the CT2 port. And this value of negative 9.7 is something that we would provide for you. That's based off of the temperature range of the sensor as well as the exact model. So here I've gone ahead and I've set that up. Let's scroll down into the register section. Here in the register section, there's a CT2 amperage. Now, of course, it's not really amperage, but that's what it's programmed and what it looks like it is here. We're saying that this is current, and then we're saying CT2. And then what we're going to do with this is we're going to tell it, well, you're not actually amperage. So we'll go over to the temperature in Celsius down here. We're going to say equals, that's a number with 3 decimals. And then here we're going to put in our formula. When we hit the dollar sign, you'll notice that all of the registers that are available pop up. So I'm going to go ahead and choose CT2 amperage. Of course, you might have labeled this something else like CT2 temperature or something. And then I'm going to put the minus 65. That's the value that we've configured here. After that, I want to go ahead, I'm going to set up a temperature in Fahrenheit, and I'm going to base that off of the temperature in Celsius, but of course multiply it times the good old ratios we learned back in grade school. All right, so now that that is set up, I can go ahead and press home. And I'm going to uncheck everything that you see on the screen for a second and go just to my temperature in Fahrenheit. You can see here that the temperature is now configured. And yesterday at about 6 o'clock when I got this set up, we can see what the temperature was. We can see it start to drop as the evening went by and the office heating turned off. And then around 7:30 in the morning, when people started coming back into the office and the heater turned back on, we got a nice spike back up to typical room temperatures. And then sometime over here, when I was fiddling with things and getting things ready for the video, disconnected everything for that first part of the video, it was disconnected, and then now we're back up and we're measuring 78 degrees inside of the lab. It's a little warm in there, it always is. All right, the next thing that we can do is we can download this data if we wanted to. We could go to export data to a spreadsheet. We would select the average value, we'd select our interval. I'm gonna choose an hour so we can see on the hour, and then go ahead and press export. What that's going to look like when I bring that into focus here is, of course, we'll get all of that hourly data. We've got everything else that the registers are configured to record. In our case, let's skip over down to the temperature Fahrenheit, and you can see where those temperatures, that data that we talked about, is recorded. All right, thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, feel free to email us at sales@aimdynamics.com. You can also call us at 303-772-6100, and we'd be happy to provide details for you. Thank you very much.